Hello, my name is Mike Hummer. I'm a solution architect with NetApp, and today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about FlexPod and specifically NVMe. So how do we take advantage of NVMe in an architecture such as a FlexPod? Well, first, let's understand a little bit about what is NVMe. If we think about disk systems until recently, they've mainly been spinning platters, where we're taking a mechanical mechanism to create ones and zeros on a bunch of magnetic disks. It works, but there's a big process that goes into ensuring the integrity of the data that we put down there. Now, moving forward, we use a lot of SSDs. Basic principle is the same in terms of our end goal. We're trying to record a bunch of ones and zeros. But the process and how we do that, very different. Enter NVMe. It's a protocol that's designed to take advantage of these modern architectures and ensuring that we get those ones and zeros recorded, but do so in a manner that's much more efficient and much more fitting for the type of media it is, a memory chip in essence. What does that translate to, though, from a customer perspective and what you can expect on your networks? Well, for one thing, because it's a much more efficient way to talk to that media, I can drastically change what I get from a response time. Typically, if I look at the controller, the protocol itself, and getting to the media, this entire stack can take anywhere from 100 milliseconds or more. In contrast, something like NVMe talking to that SSD does eliminate a lot of that overhead and can take this entire stack down to a process that might be as quick as 80 microseconds. That's a big change, particularly if you think about all the transactions that you send from your compute layer down to your storage and get the information back. That can improve significantly the performance of your applications as well as the response time. But to really take advantage of that, I have to maintain that communication through my entire stack. Now, you may know that NetApp has introduced their A800. It is a system that is designed specifically around NVMe. So from the disks, through the shelf backplane, up to the controller, and even egressing the controller, we maintain that NVMe protocol. We keep a clean communication path so that you get the benefit of that performance enhancement of the protocol. But my application doesn't run on my storage. It runs across the network on a compute layer. I have to be able to talk to it. That's where fabrics come into play. Specifically for FlexPod, we use NVMe over fiber channel, or NVMe OF. We take advantage of the latest generation of Cisco MDS switches to ensure that our communication from our storage controller to the network can maintain that NVMe. And when we talk up to the server layer, specifically taking advantage of Cisco UCS fifth generation servers, we can get a full end-to-end path of NVMe. And that's the critical part, that we are doing this from end to end. We are maximizing the benefit of that NVMe in your architecture. So how does this translate to what you can actually see in your environment? Well, from testing, we've seen response times, as I mentioned before, averaging as low as 80 microseconds. From an IOP perspective, we've seen an increase as much as 50% over straight fiber channel. These are benefits that you can take advantage of in your environment, but it's key to do it across the entire infrastructure. So in summary, NVMe, a fantastic new protocol to take advantage of today's modern media. But to make sure that we're getting the maximum benefit, we want to have an architecture that from end to end allows me to maintain it and ensure that I'm going to get that performance benefit across my entire infrastructure. If you'd like to know more, please visit us at www.flexpod.com, where you can get white papers and validated designs on end-to-end NVMe in FlexPod.